Welcome back. Right now, the International Space Station is orbiting Earth, and on board is a NASA astronaut from California. We're talking about Tracy Dyson, a UC Davis graduate and a native of Arcadia. She's on her third mission in space, and this morning, Tracy joins us live from the ISS. Thank you so much for your time. You're just hanging around in space. We appreciate it. You've spent 184 days up there right now. You return home Sunday. Are you excited?
Thanks, Mike. Yes, I'm super excited. It's been a wonderful 6 months up here. I've enjoyed the time and the camaraderie and the work, but I admit, looking forward to coming home and seeing family.
So you've been conducting a number of studies while you've been up there. One is how fire spreads in space. What kinds of applications do you think that could have?
I can think of a number of applications. Those that are kind of near and dear to our hearts at NASA are those that involve spacecraft design, space station design, spacesuit design, you name it. But anytime we come up with an understanding of any kind of physical process up here, it always has direct relevance to those that are on the ground. And so the applications are pretty widespread. But for us right now, it's in materials and spacecraft design and operations.
All right. So during 6 months, I know you've worked on a lot of projects. What do you feel might be the most interesting project that you've worked on?
Well, you know it's going to be hard to pick just one interesting project because there's several, and they range from the variety of different studies that we do, the different categories of science. One, though, that comes to mind, because my background is not in biology, is those that involve stem cells, as well as those that use 3D printing techniques in order to replicate tissue. And to me, that's just incredibly fascinating, to take a technique and try to manufacture human tissue that could help us in exploration, say, down the road, you know, if we have in such a remote environment, we can't replace organs or tissues, or we need help with healing fast and we don't have the materials there to have this kind of research at this point, I think is pretty fascinating and certainly very interesting.
Yeah, your reality right now is what a lot of folks' sci-fi is built upon. This is another question. Go back 6 months. When you first arrived or went to space, did you get motion sickness? How do you even deal with something like that when you first are going into orbit?
To answer your question quickly, no, I didn't have any space motion sickness. I've been fortunate not to have that on any of my missions. But the way that we deal with that is real simple. We have a very high-tech, they're called emesis bags, but they're really just a barf bag. And so the real simple way to handle it is that if you feel sick, you've got a means to get through it. But we also have ways to medicate in case it's really tough to adapt. But for the most part, sometimes you can just focus on an area right in front of you and try not to take in too much of your surroundings and move your head around in ways that are a little too abrupt for the experience that you're having for the first time. So there's a number of ways to overcome it, and sometimes it just takes a little time.
All right, I'm going to get you out on this question. I know you've been up there for 6 months. Have you gotten jaded? Does it ever get old to look out the window and see Earth so far away? Or are you even able to really see it?
You know it never gets old. I mean, to see our planet from this vantage point is one of the most miraculous things I can think of. The fact that we're here, that we can see our planet amidst the stark contrast of a black universe is one of the most fascinating things I can think of up here. We don't get to stare out the window very often because our timeline is pretty busy, and our opportunities to look out the window are very precious, but it absolutely never gets old.
Tracy Dyson, we appreciate your time and all the hard work you've been putting in up there at the ISS. And again, when you get home, you know, enjoy everything. You know, it's been 6 months after all. So thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, and thanks to Sacramento. I really appreciate all the support and all the encouragement.
Definitely.
What an incredible interview.